Hello everyone, I hope you guys are doing well and we are back with our another lecture. And in this lecture, I'm going to start with the case studies of unit 4, that is biodiversity and conservation. And I will be starting with the Project Tiger. So overall, we have to study 5 case studies starting with the Project Tiger. These topics are also very important from your exam perspective. So Project Tiger was launched in 1973. Indian tiger population at the end of 20th century was estimated at between 20,000 to 40,000 individuals. So in 1972, the first tiger census was conducted, and according to that census, the population of tiger at that time was left only 1800 individuals, right? So from the end of 20th century, that population was 20,000 se leke 40,000 ke beech mein, and by 1972 it left only 1800 individuals. So there was an alarming reduction in the tiger population. So as a result, in 1973, Project Tiger was launched in Palamau Tiger Reserve. And various other tiger reserves were also created in the country based on a core buffer strategy. So at present, there are total 52 tiger reserves in our country. The latest one is being created in the Rajasthan. The Project Tiger was launched in Jim Corbett National Park of Uttarakhand in 1973. So India has at present more than 103 national parks and more than 500 wildlife sanctuaries, and of which some have been declared as tiger reserve. So how many are tiger reserves? 52. Tiger reserves are governed by Project Tiger, and the centrally sponsored scheme of Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Under this scheme, a authority was created, and this is Tiger, National Tiger Conservation Authority. The name of that authority was National Tiger Conservation Authority, and aim to create it was to protect tigers from extinction by ensuring a viable population in the natural habitats, right? So government has set up a tiger protection force also under the Project Tiger to combat the poachers. And this Project Tiger also funds the relocation of villagers to minimize human-tiger conflicts, right? The most important reason at present for the reduction in the population of big cats is human and wildlife conflict, right? So this Project Tiger also funds relocation of villagers in order to minimize this conflict, right? Coming to the another case study, which is Project Elephant. Elephant, which is our national heritage animal. And few more facts I forgot to tell you about the tiger population. According to the latest census of tiger, which was conducted in 2018, and the census was made public in 2019. So according to this census, the tiger population has remarkably increased since 2016. Right, so now the population is almost 3,000 2976 tiger individuals all over the country. And Madhya Pradesh is having the highest population of tigers, right? So these were more facts about the Project Tiger and the tiger population. Let's talk about the Project Elephant. Elephant is our national heritage animal, and this Project Elephant was launched in 1992 to assist the states having free-ranging populations of wild elephant to ensure the long-term survival of identified viable population of elephants. This project is being implemented in 13 states: Andhra Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Jharkhand, Karnataka, Kerala, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Odisha, Tamil Nadu, Uttaranchal, or Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, and West Bengal. So this Project Elephant is being implemented in these 13 states. The major activities under this project are: the first is ecological restoration of existing natural habitats and migratory routes of the elephants. You must be remember, right, that jo elephants aur jo bhi wild animals hain unke extinction ka jo sabse bada karan hota hai, sabse bada reason hota hai, that is habitat loss. So the first step is ecological restoration of natural habitats, right? The second aim is development of scientific and plant management for conservation of elephant habitats and also for the population of wild Asiatic elephants in India. The third step is promotion of measure for mitigation of man and animal conflict in crucial habitats and moderating the pressures of humans and domestic stock activities in crucial elephant habitats. So this was the third step. The fourth step is strengthening of measures for protection of wild elephants from poachers and unnatural causes of death, right? To protect these elephants from poachers. This is the fourth step. Fifth step is research on Project Elephant management related issues. Sixth is public education and awareness programs. And seventh is eco-development. And eighth is veterinary care of these wild elephants, right? So at present, we are having 32 elephant reserves extending over about 58,000 square kilometers of area, right? So this was all about the Project Elephant. And Karnataka is having the highest elephant population in the country. Coming to the third case study, that is vulture breeding program. This case study is very important. And there was a question in the last year question paper on the vulture breeding program, right? So that's why it becomes very important. Vultures who feed on dead animals were once the most abundant bird across the world, including the Indian subcontinent. These vultures have ecological, social, and cultural significance in India because they perform important task of the nature, that is scavenging, because they feed upon dead animals. That's why we also call them as the scavengers of nature, right? The Persian community believes that being consumed by the scavenger bird liberates the spirit of dead. But at present, there are one of the most endangered bird species, right? So these are the nine species which are being found in India? Let's see. White-backed vulture, slender-billed vulture, long-billed vulture, Egyptian vulture, red-headed vulture, Indian griffon vulture, Himalayan griffon, Cinereus vulture, and bearded vulture. So these are the 9 species which are found in India. Why vultures are in danger? So what is the reason, right? So there is a drug named diclofenac. This is a veterinary drug, right? And used as a painkiller for animals. Animals mein use ki jati hai, isliye isko veterinary drug bolte hain, as a painkiller. So ek research ke according, पाकिस्तान इंडिया इन कंट्रीज में डाइक्लोफिनेक के यूज़ की वजह से जो वल्चर्स की पॉपुलेशन है वो डिक्लाइन हो रही है बिकॉज दिस डाइक्लोफिनेक एक्ट्स अपॉन द किडनीज एंड इट रिजल्ट्स इनटू रीनल फेलियर राइट और जो डेड एनिमल्स होते हैं उनके थ्रू फूड चेन के थ्रू ये वल्चर्स में पहुंचता है और वहां पे वल्चर्स के अंदर रीनल फेलियर की वजह से उनकी डेथ हो जाती है दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉजिंग थ्रेट टू द वल्चर पॉपुलेशन राइट सो दिस ड्रग डाइक्लोफिनेक दिस शोज बायो एक्यूमुलेशन इन वल्चर्स डाइक्लोफिनेक इज सच डेंजरसली फैटल फॉर वल्चर्स दैट इवन 1% ऑफ इट इन कैरकास would kill the vulture in a short time after it feeds such carcass right also this has the declining vulture population has a cascading effect on ecosystem let's see how vulture plays a critical role in ecosystem and their absence severely affects the health of ecosystem right and because of decline in the population of vultures the food chain is getting disturbed right and that's why there is increase in the population of feral dogs and rats which are the other scavengers in the food chain right so there are few steps which are taken by the government to save vultures so these are the conservation efforts by the government so government had released the vulture recovery plan in 2006 and under this plan 3 steps were taken the first step was to ban this drug diclofenac theek hai veterinary purpose ke liye jo use ki jati thi diclofenac so government said that we should find out the substitute of this drug alternative right so ban kar diya gaya diclofenac ko right and the Bombay Natural History Society has led the movement of vulture conservation in India the strategy is sustained conservation breeding for increasing their numbers the research and monitoring on the risks in natural habitats sensitization about vulture conservation and once there is an increase in their population of captive breeding they will be released in the identified safe zones right so this is the captive breeding of vultures right ek tarah se isko in situ conservation bol sakte hain right so conservation breeding centers banaye gaye aur ex situ conservation ke initiatives liye gaye right to is ex situ conservation ke antargat india mein 4 vulture breeding facilities establish ki gayi गुवाहाटी में पिंजौर में और वेस्ट बंगाल एंड भोपाल में राइट ऑल्सो इन सीटू कंजर्वेशन भी किया गया वल्चर्स का सो अ वल्चर सेफ हाउस इज अ जियोग्राफिकल एरिया ऑफ एटलीस्ट 100 किलोमीटर रेडियस इन सीटू कंजर्वेशन के अंतर्गत वल्चर सेफ जोन्स क्रिएट किए गए राइट और ये जो सेफ जोन्स थे वो क्या थे कि विद इन द 100 किलोमीटर ऑफ रेडियस, इस 100 किलोमीटर रेडियस को डाइक्लोफिनेक फ्री डिक्लेयर किया गया, राइट? तो इस रेडियस में किसी भी एनिमल को डाइक्लोफिनेक नहीं दी जाएगी, राइट? तो इस तरह से वल्चर सेफ जोन्स क्रिएट किए गए, राइट? सो दीज वर द स्टेप्स फॉर द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ वल्चर, राइट, बोथ एक्सीटू एंड इनसीटू. और वेन एवर देयर विल बी अ क्वेश्चन ऑन वल्चर ब्रीडिंग प्रोग्राम, यू हैव टू राइट इट, राइट? सो वॉट इज अ सस्टेनेबल प्लान फॉर फ्यूचर रिगार्डिंग वल्चर ब्रीडिंग और वल्चर कंजर्वेशन? सो इन ऑर्डर टू मेक द वल्चर कंजर्वेशन प्रोग्राम सस्टेनेबल, बॉम्बे नेचुरल हिस्ट्री सोसाइटी हैज आइडेंटिफाइड अ सेट ऑफ एक्शंस एज पार्ट ऑफ इट्स इंडिया ब्लू प्रिंट, एंड दिस इंक्लूड्स द फॉलोइंग. द फर्स्ट इज इंटेंसिफाइंग पॉलिसी एंड पब्लिक एडवोकेसी फॉर द बैनिंग ऑफ ड्रग, राइट? सेकेंड इज कॉन्टिन्यूड रिसर्च फॉर सेफर ऑल्टरनेटिव्स टू बैन ड्रग. थर्ड इज इंश्योरिंग सर्वाइवल एंड स्केलिंग अप ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ब्रीडिंग इनिशिएटिव्स. फोर्थ इज एक्सप्लोरिंग अ सस्टेनेबल लाइफ स्टॉक सोर्सिंग प्रोजेक्ट फॉर फीडिंग कैप्टिव वल्चर्स थ्रू अ कम्युनिटी बेस्ड लाइवलीहुड इनिशिएटिव्स. एंड ये जो कम्युनिटी बेस्ड लाइवलीहुड इनिशिएटिव्स हैं, इनके अंडर कई रेस्टोरेंट्स ऐसे जो आगे आए और उन्होंने डाइक्लोफिनेक फ्री जो लेफ्ट आउट्स होते हैं एनिमल्स के, वो प्रोवाइड किए टू फीड दोस वल्चर्स, राइट? अनदर इनिशिएटिव वाज वायबल एक्सपेंशन ऑफ वल्चर सेफ जोन्स, राइट? नेक्स्ट इज रिलीजिंग कैप्टिव ब्रेड बर्ड्स इनटू द सेफ जोन. एंड लास्ट इज स्ट्रेंथनिंग सेंसिटाइजेशन एंड मॉनिटरी एक्टिविटीज. सो दिस इज अ सस्टेनेबल फ्यूचर प्लान 2014 to 2025 तक, right? So that's all about the vulture breeding program. Coming to the project Great Indian Bustard. This Great Indian Bustard is found in Rajasthan, right? So Rajasthan, home to one of the last remaining population of Great Indian Bustard, has charted out a plan to recover the population of this critically endangered bird. The Great Indian Bustard is one of the heaviest flying bird, and its weight is up to 15 kg, and it can grow 1 meter in height. It is considered as a flagship species or flagship grassland species, representing the health of the grassland ecology. Nowadays, less than 200 birds are left, and of which 100 are found in Rajasthan, right? So that's why जो conservation programs हैं Great Indian Bustard के लिए, वो राजस्थान में चलाए जा रहे हैं. So because of declining grasslands and varied hunting, the population declined significantly, and in 2011 this bird was categorized as critically endangered by IUCN, that is International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. And after that, by Union Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, prepared a species recovery program for Great Indian Bustard. The lesser florican, the Bengal florican, three of the four Indian bustard species which are found in India. So all the three birds have been endemic to the grasslands of India, and the one which is Hobara, it is a migratory species, right? So four species paayi jati hai India mein, and out of these, this one species is migratory, right? Coming to the another case study, that is Save Western Ghat movement. This movement was started in 1986 and initiated by the Peaceful Society. Which is a Gandhian voluntary organization. So, Save Western Ghats founded on the principles of People's Movement for Environmental Regeneration and People's Rights and Livelihoods in Western Ghats. Right? The goal of this movement was to create an integrated ecological perspective for providing both environmental protection and the rights of rural communities, right? So this movement later on became the model for several other environmental movement in the India. And this is all about the case studies of Unit 4. I hope it is clear to everyone. Thank you.